Frozen 2.
Yeah.
So excited about this. Everyone loves the first one. And I find the relationship between the two sisters so powerful. You don't always see that. No, on Disney movies, you really never do.
Almost never. Well, yeah. We were so proud of the first one because of breaking the mold of, like, first of all, you don't see two females hit box office numbers like that. And granted, it's a cartoon, but, you know, same difference. But the reality is, in the first one, it was really important to us to break the mold of talking about romantic love. All the movies talk about romantic love. But personally, I think, and so did our creators, there are two other kinds of love that are really important to accomplish before romantic love comes along, and that's familial love and self-love. And if you don't fill up there, it's going to be messy with romantic love. So I think that's why the movie hit, because people were just encouraged that there were different types of love out there.
And the next thing is apparently the song that everyone's talking about that you relate to in some way.
Big time. Well, we sat down with the creators before this movie was written, and I mean, our writer, she journaled as Anna and Elsa for months before she wrote this script. They went and saw a psychologist to talk about, like, the girls' relationship.
Wow.
They really try to make a very authentic human element to these cartoons. And we sat down and she said, what do you think you want Anna to face or deal with? What's important? And I said, I want Anna to deal with her codependency. And the next right thing, because she lives for everyone else, and I often do that, and then when I'm alone, I don't really know what to do or how to function. And in The Next Right Thing, it's a dramatic song, but it asks this question that I was begging for us to explore that none of us talk about, which is, what do you do when you don't know what to do? Because we've all felt that, but no one talks about it. And personally, I take a lot of inspiration from my husband and his sort of, like, AA exposure and his sobriety, and it's, you just do the next right thing. You just one foot in front of the other. When I'm feeling anxious and depressed, you just get out of bed, and then you just walk and brush your teeth, and then you just have some breakfast, and you take it in tiny little steps. You just do the next right thing.
Interesting, this film also doesn't deal with the usual fodder for storytelling in the animation. Usually it's Cinderella's waiting for the prince, and this one's waiting for this damsel in distress, or they're climbing up Rapunzel's hair.
Yeah.
These are old ones. But traditionally, this one doesn't do that. This one talks about boys' emotions also.
Yes, well, that's one thing that I'm so proud of in this movie, because we do explore romantic love between Anna and Kristoff much more in this movie, but everyone talks about the way Anna and Elsa are represented as women, and I think it's more important, the things they've done with Kristoff, in that he has this huge power ballad that I think it is going to be your favorite of the movie. It's so funny. It's called Lost in the Woods. And in the beginning, he says, you feel your feelings and your feelings are real. You don't often see a guy pining over a girl in a cartoon singing about it. Kristoff's having some huge feelings and he's giving into them in this amazing cheesy way. And then there's also two lines that really pinpoint why I love his representation in this movie. Number one, he rescues Anna from something dangerous in the midst of battle. He swoops her up and the first thing he says to her is, I'm here, what do you need? He doesn't say, I've got you, stand back. He says, I'm here, what do you need? And then in the end, Anna apologizes for something, and he looks at her and says, it's okay, my love is not fragile.
Oh, I like that.
That's so great.
Deep. Very deep.
All right, this quickly before you go. It's beautiful.
I like that.
I know, right?
Wow. I'm gonna write that down.
You have a new show as well, before we go, Encore on Disney Plus. Just quickly.
Okay.
What's it about?
I'm proud of a lot of things. This might be the one that I'm most proud of. We have taken former High School Musical theater casts, reunited them. Some are millennials, haven't seen each other in 5 years. Some are baby boomers, haven't seen each other in 45 years. And they put on their high school production in 6 days. It is funny, it is heartfelt, it is like time travel. They're reintroducing themselves to people they already know, having shed the labels of high school, and it is just incredibly heartfelt.
Love it.
You know, come back all the time. Yeah. I love it when you're here. Encore. Start streaming on Disney Plus.
And today, Frozen 2 is in theaters November 22nd. If you haven't gotten a ticket yet, hurry up. We, of course, will be right back.